small toolbox.
No, you know, bread. White, squarish, full of tiny holes.
So I bet you've already heard of breadboards, the perforated prototyping tool that can make electronics plug and play. Breadboards look like flat slabs of plastic with rows of small holes that fit the wires to your sensors and actuators. Breadboards work like this. The rows on the sides are all connected vertically, and the center left and center right rows are connected horizontally. But this is easier to explain if you can just rip off the back of a breadboard and look at it. Breadboards are actually just a bunch of metal bars, and the holes in the breadboard hold your wires so they touch these bars. Since metal conducts electricity, this basically extends the reach of your wire and gives it a bunch more connections you can plug more things into. So instead of holding your components together, taping them, or permanently soldering them, you can temporarily attach them to the breadboard. This lets you test components in a way that's easy to see and understand, and you can reverse it if you make a mistake. Your breadboard holds your wires extra well, and that's because there's basically two kinds of connectors we use regularly: wire points and wire holders, also known as male headers and female headers. Both of these are equally useful and can obviously be used by anyone of any gender. Depending on what you need, you can get male-male jumper wires, male-female jumper wires, or female-female jumper wires. Most components have some kind of standard connector at one end, making it easy to plug them into your breadboard's wire holders with one of these wires. The problem is that breadboards are really big and they're meant to make temporary connections. If we want something more durable and permanent, we need to switch to a protoboard. But more on that later. For more DIY electronics and design, check out the website. Learn to hack pretty much anything at hackpretty.com.